right here, it's surrounded by all this mud. It's covered by mud, so no light is actually getting down underneath it. And so when you look down into it, it's like looking down a dark hallway or something like that. And it looks very black, but really it's just clear, you know? And if you guys look over here, there's kind of, you can see the spectrum from like darker black ice, and then it starts to get nice and blue, that blue color. And then once more sun's hit it, it gets really white and sun-crusty, sun-crusty. So that's kind of the spectrum of ice, you know? Black ice has about no light hitting it. That nice, dense, blue-looking ice has very little, just enough to see into it. But it's just like the ocean. It reflects back out blue. It has nice jackets. And then once too much light gets onto it, it gets very sun-affected and it looks white. So, you know, all this white ice we can see, there's no snow down here. You know, everything we can see is all hard glacier ice. No snow down here. It was a crevasse. And they'll think, wow, that's massive. And they'll go, throughout the season, little bugs and that kind of stuff will flutter their way unknowingly above the glacier and land somewhere, and they get really cold and their metabolism slows and they just kind of shut down, and I assume that's what the spiders eat. And so that's the only thing I know that lives out here. I've seen last season closer to the ice wall but further off that way, to the left. I saw a porcupine out here one time. Other than that, like moose and bears and stuff, if they need to get to the other side of the valley from, you know, one side or the other, they'll cross, you know, wherever they need to. They're going to take a direct route. A lot of times they're not very happy to be out here. So, like over close to the parking lot, we've seen moose poop and some moose tracks and stuff out there leading out to the white ice. So, you know, get them out here. Last season someone asked, is there ever bears on the glacier? And our guide was like, nope, never. And that day, they saw a bear poking around the toe end out here. But yeah, not usually. There's like no real food source out here for them. And they can get water elsewhere. So.
Thank you.
actually, you can see this crevasse, actually, tiny little crevasse, this crack running through this water. And it finds a little weakness, and as it starts to flow into it, it's just melting away. And so as soon as it starts to flow in, it's getting bigger and bigger every day. So this is still in the really early stages. This is a really small little guy, which we can get up close and personal to, because nobody's going to fall down in there and get deposited out into the river, you know. But we do see these guys, not so much, a little bit, you know, down here on the toe end, but more so back on top of the ice fall and way back behind. Massive, massive moulons, with like full rivers flowing into them. I mean massive. Some of them, there's one like 4 miles up, that we've been calling T-Rex moulon, and we lowered down into it and climbed up and out and done all this kooky stuff. But it's big enough that, you guys seen Jurassic Park, the T-Rex that comes walking up, you could throw like 10 of those guys into this thing. You seriously could stack up 3 vertical school buses, like side by side, and fit them into this moulon. It's massive. So sometimes they get ginormous, and it's just depending on how much water is flowing into it, and if that water kicks back on and flows back into it season after season, you know? Something like this, down here on the toe end, usually what happens, you got a moulon here, got another one right there, maybe uphill of this stream, maybe a crevasse opens right here, this little tiny one, and then a new moulon forms. And then the next year, this one happens up here, you know? And so down here on the toe end of the glacier, they generally don't get a whole lot bigger than this, maybe, you know, this big or so. Okay. But pretty cool. Good eye, Steve. Yeah, it's a cool one. And so all this water drains into it and is exiting. You guys see that second creek that we drove over with the little bridge? Most of that water, in fact, I would go as far as say almost all that water is exit moulon water. So, yeah, that little creek didn't start flowing until July 16th. And I really wish we were all heading out of that. But started flowing July 16th, and that's just kind of when we reckon that all these moulon vents, you know, underneath the glacier finally unmelted, or, you know, unfroze, melted open, and it's like someone turned on the floodgate. It'll flow for like 2 months, and then it'll shut back off when things start to freeze out here, you know, all these guys fill back up. Pretty cool though. deep, deep underneath this is all just bedrock, you know? So permafrost within like that kind of stuff, the dirt. Deep beneath this is just bedrock underneath. What's going on here, they estimate is that or hypothesize rather, there's some big feature underneath this section, like a cliff face or something. That usually as the glacier moves, it just bulldozes everything out of the way. But there's something here, like some kind of drop off, that this is acting kind of like a waterfall here on the glacier. So normally, when water falls off a cliff, it's sort of cresting over the edge there, you know, and it's going from this to like that, right? And so the ice is trying to do that too. And as it comes over this edge, it's sort of, you know, these crevasses are opening, and these layers of ice are just peeling open like the pages of a book. You know, if you're open a book like that. Say a crevasse opens right here, and then slowly is moving this way, and another crevasse opens, and I have this sheet of ice in the middle, and it's gonna melt out until it's like this knife blade, or like a shark fin, you know? And we call those siracs, okay? The sirac is kind of this knife blade ridge. So that's what's happening. All this ice is moving very quickly right here. This is like, picture this like a river. This is like the rapids of this river, you know? And way out, the moraine out to either side, way out, have kind of like eddies. Very slowly circulating out to the sides. This is where all the action's happening very quickly. So you get all this turbulence. And the top third of the glacier, you know, is usually very brittle. And the bottom, like, half or two-thirds is really malleable, actually. Ice, glacier ice can actually be considered